In this video, I will show you all six players that you need to succeed for the Monday Night Football Showdown Captain Mode slate on DraftKings. My name's Quick Pick Nick, and having simulated a couple hundred thousand different roster combinations, here are your Lacks and Lotteries for tonight, Monday, November 30th. If you like this kind of fast-paced, calculated content, subscribe and stay tuned for more lineups throughout the season, including a FanDuel Thursday Night Football video coming soon. To start off this lineup with our first lock, one of the most intriguing options at MVP my model found is Chris Carson. There were a multitude of combinations that involved many different MVPs for this slate, so there wasn't a definitive MVP according to my model, but after further inspection, it became clear that Carson should be in the 1.5 times position. By selecting Carson instead of a more expensive option like Russell Wilson, we save up to $5,700 on DraftKings. It doesn't seem like we'll be missing out on many points either, as before Carson's injury, Carson was managing 16 fantasy points per game in weeks 1 through 5. Additionally, compared to Philadelphia's tough pass defense, which ranks in the top 5 for both passing yards and touchdowns allowed per game, the Eagles' rush defense is much weaker and more vulnerable, ranking in the bottom 5 for both rushing yards and touchdowns allowed per game. This option could be seen as a risky pick, considering Carson is coming fresh off an injury and that we're passing up on taking a quarterback's guaranteed numbers here instead, but the stars are aligned for Carson to have a huge comeback game tonight. Another player primed for a comeback game is our second lock, the quarterback on the other side of the ball, Carson Wentz. Although he's had a rough couple of games recently, tonight might be Wentz's revival as he faces the worst secondary in the league by a large margin, allowing over 340 passing yards per game to opposing quarterbacks, in addition to nearly 2 passing touchdowns allowed per game. Plus, if you take a deeper look at those poor fantasy performances through weeks 10 and 11, Wentz didn't really have horrible yardage, managing 208 and 235 passing yards against the Giants and Browns defenses respectively. With a much easier opponent, Wentz should be able to continue to produce a few hundred passing yards, which would be more than enough points to justify his selection. One potential concern is Jalen Hurts' involvement in the offense, as it has been reported that Hurts might see an expanded role as soon as tonight's contest. But I personally don't think that Hurts will be forced into this offense so abruptly, and that we will instead see a steady increase in usage over time. The third lock of this lineup is Russell Wilson, which is for mostly obvious reasons at this point, but he's just a player we can't afford to ignore. After stumbling a bit recently against the Rams, one of the strongest defensive teams in the league, Wilson should be able to continue his MVP-like dominance, as although the Eagles' pass defense is stronger than their rush defense, the caliber of defense really hasn't seemed to matter outside of that Rams slugfest, with Wilson scoring more than 20 fantasy points in every other game, including against demanding opponents including the 49ers and Bills. The price doesn't really matter because although taking Wilson will leave a pretty big dent in our budget, he's the only player who can consistently score these high numbers, meaning he might be that make or break player for lineups in this contest. For the fourth and final lock of this lineup, my model chose Richard Rodgers, mainly because of his low cost on DraftKings. For only $1,800, we're able to get a player who has scored 10 or more fantasy points in both of his past two contests, including a touchdown last week. Over his past three contests, Rodgers has seen more attention with an average of 5 targets per game, and with that kind of volume against Seattle's kind of secondary, we should be able to get plenty of points to warrant this very low price tag. For the two lotteries, my model found a couple of other Eagles receivers who will likely benefit alongside Wentz and Rodgers in this Seahawks horrible pass defense, as to round out the lineup, my model picked Travis Fulgham and Greg Ward. The reasons for these two selections are similar to that of Rodgers, as we'll be able to take advantage of Seattle's bad defense with these players' regular volume in Philadelphia's offense. Fulgham is averaging 8 targets per game, with Ward averaging 5.5, which are both plenty of opportunity to make something happen against this defense that allows for big plays to be made. That's what my model was able to come up with for the Monday Night Football single game showdown captain mode on DraftKings tonight, November 30th, 2020. This has been Quick Pick Nick, the intersection for sports, data analysis, and speed. Thanks for watching.